Sigmund from Ratchet and Clank was kind of fun, just because, you know, it's so silly to be able, you know, do a voice that I used to do for my, you know, nieces and nephews when they were little. Oh, there's so many.
I love being surprised, like when I like watching Rick and Morty.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, and then all of a sudden, I'm just enjoying the episode, and then I hear his voice. Stupid voice.
Yeah,
one and of them, it's yeah. It's so much fun.
That was Pluto. Feel that? Just got a little smaller.
I was Scroopy Noopers.
Just got a little smaller.
It's stuff like that, and if we're playing a game or we're watching, like Fred Tatasciore is here, and the last three seasons of Family Guy, I've heard yeah. Fred in every episode. And especially when it's a friend, you get really excited and you feel like you're celebrating with them. It's like watching somebody run a, you know, 50-yard touch in the wrong place to make that joke. Except for the footballer. It's those kind of things that I love. But
keep going.
No. That's as far as I can take that metaphor. But it's to me, some of those really smaller, obscure roles are the ones that kind of... Every time, man, you're cutting your teeth. This is just my man. Every one of those small roles has somehow advanced you further. A buddy of mine, Glenn Morshower, said it's all about singles and doubles. It's about another baseball metaphor. Damn, I never make sports metaphors. But it's not about every time hitting it out of the park. It's about, you know, getting it on. I was containing within the metaphor.
He meant cricket.
Yes.
Nobody understands.
This is my life.
Brits don't even understand. Like,
he's like this when we're having lunch. Just
metaphor, 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 dick joke.